Back into Disco Elysium, back into the world of Revachol. See what else is going on. Kim is still gone. Almost 2 p.m. We'll take another look at our tasks quick. Got one skill point. Oh, right, the basement door. I was gonna do that. Does it say on there when Kim is gonna be back? I think he's gonna be back tomorrow. I think we spend the whole day without him here.
There. Working class drunk. You know what this means, right?
Hey, Saul.
Cracked it. All in a good day's work.
What did I crack? Mean,
what did I crack? Look at how working class that drunk is.
It's the missing husband. Oh my god. Future leader of a proletariat uprising. It's the missing husband.
And you found him. Now go and tell the working class woman. Protect and serve, recruit.
This doesn't add up.
Do marriages make any sense? Does honor? You're not a filthy philosopher. You're an officer of law.
The internet is tired as well.
To ace this case and not brood over your reputation. We can deal with the perception management later.
She's gonna be mad at me if I do this. Oh my god. Misa, we need to do something about your hair. Ridiculous. Alright.
There's no need for champagne when there's honor, recruit. Go and tell the world.
Alright, let's see what she says. Hey lady, I found your husband.
God damn it, I already told you. My husband isn't missing. And I specifically added that I didn't need to know where he was. Very well then. Where is he?
Right around the corner, he's pissed himself.
Excuse me? I don't follow.
There's something else hiding in her voice, though. A trace of worry.
Found a working class drunk. I thought it might be yours.
Because working class women come with alcoholic husbands.
Well, now I feel like a bastard.
You know what? You were right. I do have an alcoholic husband. Although not that one.
Is he all right?
I did, and he is. He's also an alcoholic.
Is he also missing?
No, he's not. Or maybe he is. I don't know. He's probably in the park or in Shamrock somewhere. Drinking with his friends.
How you doing, Globo?
I haven't seen him for... Well, to hell with him!
There. She's worried now.
Poor lady.
She sighs, but you can detect a slight hint of gratitude and relief from her face.
I'm supposed to feel that way? Okay, so it's not just me.
All right, go ahead. Do you have any questions?
What does he look like?
Honestly, not that different from you.
Oh, shit.
That's one way to put it, yes. No offense. I'd also add he's a little bit chubby.
Okay.
What else? He was wearing a dark brown leather jacket with a bright blue inner lining. The lining is hand-sewn. I made it myself. It's his cool jacket. God knows it's too cold to run around in this, but he refuses to change.
Aww.
Who cares about the cold when you have your cool jacket to wear? You can completely simplify.
I get it.
I even tried throwing it away once, but he just dug it out of the bin. Can you believe it?
If it's that
well,
cool.
What can you do? I hope that at least that extra lining helps him keep warm at night. I wouldn't like him to catch cold.
She's thinking about him out in the cold, in some park, or on the coast. it's making her more and more worried.
When did you last see him?
Yesterday morning. He went to the library. He went to retrieve my book, and he promised he'd walk straight back home. Because we talked about this. We talked about not wandering off again. I don't know what to do. I honestly don't know what to do with his addiction. Just makes me feel weak.
She turns away from you in an attempt to recover.
All right, I got it.
So you are going to look for him.
She genuinely wants you to know. Don't make her ask.
Yeah.
Thank you. Please do. Even though I'm sure he will return home by himself. I'm still sure of that.
She tries to maintain a brave front, even though her eyes reveal the opposite.
I wonder if he's across the bridge down the coast a little bit. Wasn't there another? There's plenty of drunks at the Whirling in Rags. Kuno does not fucking care. Maybe I'm her missing husband. I'm not, I don't think I'm chubby enough. The way she said he looked like me, but chubby. Or maybe I'm her husband and I lost a little weight. Hi, Miso. You're so cute. Morning cup of nudes. Lightfall launch day. Is that a Destiny thing? Happy Lightfall launch day. Brown leather jacket with a bright blue lining. Yeah, he's probably over on the coast. I don't think I have any bottles, but...
The tear machine stands in the corner.
Gonna need 10 more dollars for my hotel room tomorrow night. How hard is it to find a single metal ball?
Very large red t-shirt with an impressive print stands out from the other garb.
Oh yeah?
Oh yeah. The print depicts a muscled man striding toward you, a giant sword in each hand, encircled by burning embers.
Sick.
Behind him is a cluster of cabins engulfed in flames. Beneath him are the words, Heimdall burning.
Sniff it.
Smells like worn cotton and a little old sweat there. Worn cotton with a side of flea market or trash bin.
Sniffing is okay, but please don't try anything on. Can't have you leaving your photon emissions in the fabric of things you're not going to buy.
You're not.
Of course, not the photon emissions.
Photon emissions? What is he talking about?
What's the deal with the man?
That's the man from Hjelmdal walking away as his village burns.
He's surprised at your non-recognition.
Who's that again?
The man from Hjelmdal is the hero of a series of popular books based on a fictional version of Kotla. Mostly what is nowadays Arda NFD.
It's okay, Miso, you can stay there. Well, this one apparently has no batteries, so... Alright, go on. Alright. The other controller just isn't even charging. I got this like a month ago. Completely dead and won't charge. Great. Are you charging? You are charging. Awesome. Thank you, Sony. You send me a VR thing that the controller doesn't work properly. Send me a controller with a basically dead battery. And over half of the DualShock 4 controllers I have stick drift, so... God damn it. And I need to fix my Switch Pro controller. How many broken controllers? I take good care of my shit, man. I take good care of my stuff. I don't know. I don't know what I can do different. But. Bender, are you jacking on in there? Okay, whatever. The game will go on.
He left his native village of Hjelmdal after his son was kidnapped. Having many exciting adventures and killing many enemies with his swords. But he lost his family in the process. Tragic stuff, really.
How much is
it? 2 real.
Could you just give it to me for free?
Why?
Can't think
You'll
of a good reason.
Have to buy it then, but it's not like it's expensive.
Celine Dion, yeah. This is a pretty badass shirt. Yeah.
A typical Martinez streetlight. Sits among assorted floor and table lamps.
Yes, is that a streetlight?
As you see, it's in perfect working order.
His manner is casual, but his speech is careful, measured. He wants you to know that he has nothing to hide.
Where'd you get it?
It was brought to me to be altered.
The light's buzzing resembles the purring of a
How's it going, Gergs?
It seems very much at home here.
Let your gaze run over the streetlight.
Has been carefully cut, and the wiring has been redone and attached to a standard indoor plug. The light buzzes faintly, but persistently.
How much?
700 real. A bargain, I dare say.
A bargain? No, it's not. He's trying to sweet-talk you into buying trash.
seems a bit steep.
There's also the matter of rewiring. But the most important transformation is the light's placement among ordinary indoor fixtures, which has adjusted its morphological field. The light became suitable for use inside the home just a few days ago.
This guy's high as shit. Right, let's get the hell out of here. Actually, can I talk to him first before we completely leave? There we go.
Hello, hello. Let me know if I can help you with anything.
I just need a single metal ball, man. Let's head back toward the whirling. Okay, so that's the door up there on the right that I need to open. As much as I don't want to help. What's his name? Wait. Okay, never mind. I just noticed the L3 and R3 icons down in the bottom right. It looks like those are for your hands, but they didn't do anything. Probably only for specific uses.
This must be it. The basement door is weather-worn. The copper nails holding the upholstery in place have turned green from sea air, and there's a knocker shaped like a lion's head. The leather upholstery is worn and rough against your jaw. You don't hear any movement. In fact, it's oddly silent in the yard around you. No birds chirp.
Knock.
You knock silently. The upholstery muffles the sound. No response comes from the apartment.
Let's open the door.
You try to be as silent as you can. It takes a bit of rattling of the handle to loosen the bolt. Finally, the door unlocks with a small clack. Thoughts race through your head. Only curiosity could account for stepping over that threshold. Maybe there's treasure in there. A white alligator, a fountain of quicksilver.
Only one way to find out.
As you hold the open door, you can feel the air moving. A little draft, a whistle. A row of mugs sits on the shelf. Each one depicts a human figure. A dark-skinned woman grinning amidst mysterious symbols. A broad-shouldered man shoveling potatoes and others.
Walk past Kuno without a word to him? There's nothing to say to Kuno. I feel like if I tap on these, they're all going to fall down.
Ring. Though cheerful, the images on the ceramic make you vaguely uncomfortable. The images betray a lack of interest in human beings. They are merely unflattering caricatures.
What do I mean
the
uncomfortable?
Owner of these mugs doesn't like people of other ethnicities very much.
Oh, well, then he's, yeah.
This
typical asshole
is unhappy.
Fair-haired fantasy heroes with big muscles. Who doesn't? Taking their shirt. Well, maybe I shouldn't. I don't want to dress like a racist. Magnesium. Looks like they're packing for something. Or guests staying over. That too. I think's more likely, but whatever. The hidden world of walking sticks. Red sun. doesn't seem like there's anything else here. I got a new shirt. Put that one on instead. We can say hi to Kuno, even though he's not going to say anything anyway. No, you're not going to go through the door when I click on the door? Thank you. Not yet, Pisser comes stand. Don't worry, we'll break it in. Now we can probably go talk to Everard again. As much as I don't like talking to Everard. Tequila Sunset is on the case.
Fuck, does Kuno care?
Fuck, does Kuno care?
Kuno doesn't fucking care.
Doesn't fucking care. There you go. Kuno check complete. All right. Is the racist lorry driver have anything else to say?
Looking for something odd? Come to tell me to fuck off again?
Yeah, I kind of want to. Just you wait. There's going to be a big twist at the end where it turns out Kuno really does care. M. Night Shyamalan wrote that one. Today's gonna be a long Tuesday, I can feel it. I think that's locked. Yeah. The real caring was the speed we did along the way. You actually slept last night? Nice. I always wake up around 4 lately. An hour before my alarm goes off. I usually get back to sleep and everything, it's just weird that it keeps happening.
Mr. Dubois, every worker.
For himself. A member of the board.
That's right, Mr. Dubois. I see the socialist democratic fervor now burns in your heart, too. How can I help you today?
I open the door.
I'm very glad to hear that, Harry. One question. You didn't actually happen to stumble in and see what's inside the apartment, did you?
There is no way to sway this man in any direction. He is unsuggestible and unswayable. Just tell the truth.
Yeah.
Just as I thought. Culturally antiquated mug collection. What a weasel. Pissing on Everart's Rainbow Coalition. Now let's get down to brass tacks. It's time for men like me and you to figure out who's killed who and why. Real police work is gonna start happening now. I promise you, Harry, this is gonna be good.
Connection between the lynching and the strike. I'd like to hear what you know about it.
By now, I'm sure you've figured out who the dead man was working for. The bad guys.
Kuno asked telling you to fuck the corpse.
sent to scare us. Another violent measure of the top hats against us flat caps.
I'm listening.
Harry, this strike is the culmination of many, many mistakes made by the Wild Pines group. They tried to shut the strike down by sending in armed mercenaries.
Our victim?
A security contractor. Can you imagine that? Workers standing in peaceful protest, united in the spirit of fellowship, and they send hired killers to mow us down with machine gun fire.
He performs a motion as if spraying bullets from a machine gun.
I'm talking beasts, hardened killers from proxy wars in Yisut, Seminine, Saramaritsa. You name it, they've done it. Raping, killing, burning villages, killing little children for the Senarisa Pineapple Company, Harry. Everything they did there, they brought over here. They want to turn Revachol into a third world slum. Honestly, the only thing they didn't do is kill the village elephant.
Dang. A bit disappointed I managed to miss the dumbest game over in the game during the corpse investigation. I heard, didn't somebody tell me that they died in the first 5 minutes because they had a heart attack trying to turn on the light or something? You can do that? All right, you have a village elephant?
No, Harry, the elephant is metaphorical, and so is the village, but the mercs and their brutality are very real.
Go on.
Now, I haven't personally witnessed the brutalities out there. I have the luxury of staying in my container, you see. If I need to go somewhere, they just move my container.
Uh-huh.
Yes, I'm an old man, Harry. My legs aren't what they used to be. They lift my office with that big crane. It's actually very fun. You should try it.
Your legs aren't what they used to be, and it looks like your neck isn't
enough
either.
Enough about me and my fun container. The killers the company hired, I think there were three of them, all hardened commando types. One of them got downright suicidal, getting drunk, violent, a little rapey.
Just a little
bit.
Even
their own negotiator couldn't control him. That's your boy, the one who likes hanging out and trees.
How did he end up hanging from the tree?
Harry, what you need to realize is, we dock workers are not pushovers.
Uh-huh.
We got grit, Harry. This whole neighborhood does. Push us hard enough, and we push back. And when we do, we push to kill.
Who did the pushing?
There's a militant wing inside the union. A group of people whose duties don't involve manual labor, but peacekeeping in the neighborhood, making sure everything runs smoothly. They're like you, idealistic people who want to make sure that bad things don't happen. And if they already have, well, punishment must follow.
You believe they killed him?
One day Titus Hardy, leader of this peacekeeping faction, comes up to me and says, "Boss, socialist democratic fervor drove us to take it upon ourselves to kill this beast that was burdening the land." He probably worded it differently, but that was the idea. Sure sounded to me like they killed him. I gave them 2 weeks paid leave and told them to lay low to avoid retaliation.
Are you not afraid that we're going to arrest him?
No, I'm not at all worried about that. These are not the kind of men who get arrested. They're Martin A's boys, tough and gritty. I'd like to see the man who takes them in. Besides, I sent my lawyer girl to look after them.
Despite his boastful tone, he's having doubts about something. But what? Maybe he doesn't believe the boys really had it in them. They're his boys, after all.
I think you're sharing information because you don't think they actually did it.
That's very clever, Harry. Yes, they might have said it just to impress some girls or something. But Titus has a bad temper, so the chances are 50-50.
How do you know they were hired by the shipping company?
How do I know? Let me tell you about these people. That's their MO. It's what they do.
Gut feeling, got it.
Last winter, some poor workers in Terminal E went on a little strike. The company sent in Sediment, a security contractor. The strike was over the workers' right to wear protective footwear, Harry. These guys turn up and start beating people. Tell you what, Harry, I wouldn't be surprised if we got the same mercenary company after a little rebranding. And I'm sure as hell not surprised to see an army of scabs under my gates.
You think the security contractor organized the scabs?
You said it, Harry. Hell,
we can talk to the scabs, I guess.
One of those guys looks big enough to take down that proverbial elephant.
Pardon me
a
moment.
Boys like that don't just happen to show up during strikes.
Said it, Harry, one of those guys looks big enough to take down that proverbial elephant. Don't just happen to show up during strikes.
He's not scared of them. If anything, he likes them being here. Strange.
Likes them. This charging cable is like just barely not long enough, so I have to like hold it closer to the console. All right, the lawyer girl.
This is a bright one. I paid for that law degree myself, thinking it'll probably turn her all fancy. But hell, Harry, she came back a firebrand socialist. Sometimes she scares me with her zeal.
All right, whose place is that? I wonder if it's connected to my case.
Believe me, he's not a killer. He's a nobody. Just a basement variety armchair fascist who comes up with needlessly complex conspiracy theories.
Did one of his theories turn out to be true?
What if it did? What if he took a whack in the dark, started telling people the strike is funded by a protection racket that drove local shops out of business? What if he planned to write a hack piece to the local newspaper regarding these crazy theories he had developed, just to stir up trouble? Wouldn't that be annoying?
Why can I not scroll up right now? I see.
Journalism, Harry.
Morning, werewolf.
I love it. You love it. And you know why? Because we've got nothing to hide.
Now I can.
Let's keep it that way.
Interesting.
Now, please, let's get back to the good stuff. The police stuff, Harry.
Of course.
I just see myself as one of you guys.
Oh my God, shut up. Titus Hardy.
Simply fine young men, all seven of them. Exemplary union members.
There's eight.
Always working to advance their position in the local socialist democratic movement. Core members. Old Theo used to run them, but things really kicked into gear when Titus took the reins and named the group after himself. Gotta love his initiative.
Who's second?
Harry,
who's the most violent?
Almost all of them great guys, born leaders.
Wonderful people.
Whatever happened, I'm sure they only had the best interests of Revachol in mind. Work with them. Hell, interview them. But don't fight them. They really are just like you. Men who like beer, women, and some order on the streets.
I met them. Can you ask
but
them to cooperate?
It's the least I can do for my good friend Harry.
Good. You can now go and tell Titus about this.
Also, Harry, here's 5 real.
No, I don't need your money.
I wasn't offering it to you, just holding it out there. But I'm willing to share information. Was there anything
Here's
else?
A $5 bill. For no reason.
Was it a
All right, good
tool?
Talk. No, it wasn't.
I'm not sure we made much headway here. I was hoping we'd bust the case wide open. Heck, I even wanted to tell you what I really want to achieve with the strike. I don't know what happened, Harry. I wanted you to feel like Mr. Martinez. And, of course, I also wanted you to find your gun. But it's like I can't completely trust you. Yet. Yes, Harry. It's like I can't fully trust you if you're not a
You took all the money he offered you?
I want to, but I just can't.
Dude, I want to find my gun and use it on him. He's so annoying. I hate his, I hate his confidence.
He's been hurt too much in the past by men who aren't social democrats.
I'm a patriot of Revachol.
Just between us, I don't care for those lefty dinks either. It's all about power, and here's how we're gonna get it. I need you to be my kingsman, Harry.
I'm not your fucking lapdog.
Kingsman? Yes. Please, let's be that.
Once what would again, this entail? I require nothing unethical or illegal of you.
Sure.
You just need to get two little signatures on this piece of paper, and then mail it to my accountant in La Delta.
What are they for?
I'm glad you asked, Harry. The union is going to build a modern youth center in Martinez. It will be righteous. We're gonna get those teenagers off drugs and on roller skates.
Why not both?
There's a nameless little street on the coast with some old houses around it. Most people have already signed. I just need two more signatures to get this mission off the ground, Harry.
What if, hear me out, drugs on roller skates? Great. Current occupants.
They're just gonna have to deal with the construction noise for 6 months, and then they'll be living like kings. Right next to a fancy new youth center designed by the best architects from Stella Marie.
Where is it?
On the coast, Harry, across the canal. There's a cul-de-sac there, a little village they're calling it. A gloomy place. You'll find it. I trust your detective skills, Harry.
All right.
Water drips from the eaves. A woman looks at her freshly tarred skiff. There's a pair of cavalry boots under the fish in the box, and the wind howls like a vicious spirit.
I don't want to keep doing shit for him. He annoys me. Getting bad vibes.
Perfectly acceptable. No one's gonna force you into anything, but I don't know about that gun of yours. You see, I'm a vengeful man, Harry. Part of how I got where I am is that, well, I can be quite nasty sometimes.
What the hell are you gonna do? You have to use a crane to move you anytime you want to go anywhere.
The good news is, the moment you change your mind and want to look into this matter, just tell me, and we'll be buddies again.
Few details about the murder again?
Most certainly, Harry. Nothing brightens my day like brainstorming these things with you. Why? Believe me, he's not a killer. What if it did? What if he took a whack in the dark, started telling people the strike is funded by a protection racket that drove local shops out of business?
Just wanted to hear that again.
To write a hack piece to the local newspaper regarding these crazy theories, journalists. Now, please, let's get back to the good. By all means, Harry.
Okay.
What's on your mind?
Leaving. So we can talk to Titus now. I can get the hell out of his office. It'll never not be irritating in this game. Selecting a door and it just stays highlighted for a little while, and then he just doesn't open it and just gives up. Alright. It's a pull, not a push. Guess what? I get to talk to Titus.
I've got nothing to say to you. Why are you wasting your time?
Are you the Hardy girl?
I am not.
You could be, Liz. You could be anything. You could even be a model.
Oh, Glenn's got a crush.
Even a mod? Glenn, I went to law school. I am an attorney.
He's right. With a face like that, she could be on the cover of Le Debutante International.
Yeah, eat shit, Glenn.
So fucking what? Lots of models are actually really smart people, fuckwad.
No, Glenn. They aren't.
Looks like the circus left town, but the clowns are still here.
Just the one clown, actually. Oh, Ever, I promise you,
so
cooperate.
You went and talked to my mommy, and now she's making me play with you. Is that it, lawman?
Yep.
And what's gonna happen if we don't?
I'm gonna tell your mommy, and she's gonna give you a big old spanking right on your bottom. Premature, guys.
Yeah, I heard him. Now, fuck do you think I'm doing here? You'd have your ass handed to you if it wasn't for the boss man's word. Let me state this very clearly, capo. Hello, officer. I'm Titus Hardy, and these are my boys. Hardy boys. How may we assist you?
Explosive laughter follows. To his men, Titus Hardy is a golden god. They want to laugh at his jokes even before they leave his lips. This guy is a born leader.
Sure.
Establish
we knew
authority.
That was gonna fail.
Yes. Authority. Feverish thoughts race through your mind.
That's all
Did
I got.
Did you already try the gun thing? I hear the gun thing is excellent and has great results.
And what exactly is it you've been doing that's so goddamn special? Shitting yourself in front of us. Going around, harassing kids on the street. Kids who've done nothing wrong.
It's alright, the kids don't fucking care.
All the while talking racist shit. Don't think we aren't watching fascia. People here trust us. We're getting complaints.
Is there anything racist?
Of course
what?
You have. You've been calling people kipped left and right. Inciting race violence in my town.
Kali said they've been trying to set up a race rally, whatever the fuck that means. Trying to get the Kips out of Revershaw before the economy goes to shit.
Why?
Show their ears. Kali said they're bulk purchasing confetti.
Wouldn't surprise me if it's actually happening.
And loudspeakers. And fireworks. Kali works at the carnival shop, you see.
Get the fuck out of here, you racist carny. There'll be no race rally in my town.
What's going on? Are you racist now? Is the rally real? Please don't set up any rally. It'll make you look awful.
I'm not gonna set up a damn rally. I'm gonna talk to him again in a second. All right, see you later, Val. Authority, 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 authority. Shit. Wait, I have a something is giving me less authority here. Oh yeah, get rid of the glasses. All right, let's try again.
Looks like the circus left town.
But the clowns are still here. Ha ha ha, it was a funny joke the first 10 times. Locked? Oh, I still need to put a point in there, damn it. Fine, we'll give it a shot.
Looks like
Zerka's left town, but the clowns are still here.
Clowns are still here.
Oh my god, so original. Such a funny joke.
This time it's going to work. You already ruled out them.
And what blah, blah, blah. The while talking.
Kali said they've been trying. Great, it's gonna, just gonna damage my morale each time.
Get the
what's going. There is no rally. Come on.
God damn it. Oh, I want to talk about the murder though. Great, we get to hear his joke again. Great.
Looks like the circus left him, but the clowns are still here.
Okay. The hanging.
Again.
Good one, Titus.
You murdered him just like that?
How many people have you sent to the Shays? Ever felt remorse for them?
Or send them to reunion to rot? For 20 years? For life?
What I do? Bad people, criminals.
Rest assured, lawman. None worse than our guy.
Okay, he got fair enough.
Coming to him.
Wow, so getting Everett telling these guys to cooperate got me nothing else. Ow.
We hanged him up.
Didn't they teach you?
You're pretty sure you've had at least 2 years of cop school and many more of...
Maybe you wrap it up instead? You don't
when?
Have to keep on...
I know, Lizzie. Relax. We killed him last Sunday night.
Next
Why
question.
Not?
Okay,
Let
well, whatever.
Hear off.
Okay.
About fucking time.
I'm leaving. I don't know where I'm going, but I'm leaving. Let's take a look at our tasks. The husband, I think I have to go over to the other side. The water lock. He's probably also, yeah, he's also in that same area. Prove your authority. Look for a witness, get help from the union boss, blah, 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 blah. Or the company rep. We could go talk to, let's talk to the lady on the boat. I forget her name. The one who works for Wild Pines. Everett really wanted me to talk to her, apparently. It was weird how he kept bringing her up.
You're back. Good. What can I help you with? Not an umbrella, I hope. I don't need one myself, you see.
Mm-hmm.
All around you. Rain keeps falling down on the wooden boards she's standing on and on the water around you.
What a weird way to start a conversation. I don't need an umbrella. See you later, Cup of Nudes. Have a good day. I could use a coat like
Sadly,
that.
Sadly, I need this one myself. It's hydrophobic.
Yeah, I wasn't asking for yours.
Almost
I was admiring
magically.
It.
The company makes them for offshore platform personnel. Very sturdy.
Right.
What I can do for you is answer some questions. Nothing like talking to pass a rainy day.
Talk to me
of
about
course.
The strike. What do you think of Everard?
Claire is a man of the utmost integrity. If you can say one thing about him... It's that he always puts the interests of the workers first.
Okay.
Of course not. Everard is fantastically corrupt. I imagine he has a thick, viscous goo where you and I have blood.
Kind of sounds like him, yeah?
He's the most corrupt individual I have ever seen, and I deal with men like him for a living. If there is anyone more venal, more irredeemably nepotistic, then it's his twin brother, Edgar.
I remember hearing something about
Have
this Edgar.
Him?
No.
Edgar looks exactly like his brother, except for that lazy eye. He also talks exactly like Evrat does. And when one's term as foreman is up, the other takes over. It's how they circumvent the term limits, you see, with a funny little switcheroo. While in office, they've embezzled God knows how much of their workers' dues.
What about the union itself?
The Debardeurs Union was once a perfectly normal institution. 20 years ago, anyway. It must not have been easy to establish under the Emergency Act. But they did it. I can respect that. Organized labor at its best, as they say. Then something happened in the local chapter elections. The brothers Clare came and transformed it into a... How do you say?
Giant leech.
Or a mob. Sadly, Warpines.
That's the other one I was going
to
say.
What amounts to a crime syndicate for 2 decades. However much you feed the wolf always hungers.
Okay.
There are leaflets everywhere. And... Every worker, a member of the board.
She nods.
Of course.
Different topic.
Don't tell her you've met Evra right away. This time.
Okay, okay, okay. That's kind of the whole reason I came over here, but I'll listen to my inner monologue, I suppose. Drug trafficking.
The lorries are still stuck at the roundabout. If the police is asking, one of the drivers might admit to it.
I don't know that... I don't want to give her that information. That we think one of the drivers was there. We have proof that the union is involved.
How do you think they're financing this strike? There are thousands of unpaid dock workers going strong for the 4th month straight. It's true they drove a number of the local businesses to bankruptcy preparing for this venture. I've talked to a few business owners. It was quite the shakedown. But the contents of a few cash registers cannot provide for 2,000 men.
Okay.
Precisely. Smuggled out of that very gate at night, most likely. Then loaded onto lorries and driven to Jamrock. You simply need to find one driver who will open up to you.
It sounds like she tried looking into it herself. Though she's clearly not the type your typical lorry man would confide in.
All right, let's discuss something else.
Wow, you work hard.
I work so hard.
Oh, yes, you hustle. You're a provider. It's tough out there, but you keep it real and provide. Oh yeah.
Hell yeah.
Like a horse, a workhorse for hard work.
What hard work do I do?
Look at yourself. You're a human pedometer. You must have walked 200,000 steps down cracked asphalt, mosaic, sand.
How did he pronounce asphalt there? That was like the weirdest. Asphalt?
That is the sign of a hustler who never gives up. The world
yeah,
is
I take a lot of steps.
And people are evil. You didn't make it that way. And you won't let it break you. You ride.
Ride till I die, bitch.
That's just what it's like. Life and death. But you got gills on your side, baby. Got those black papers with the faces of the innocents on them. You
I love the thought of him, like, just finishing
souls.
This conversation with this woman and then just standing there while he has a conversation with himself in his head.
It ain't easy, but you do it.
She's, like, trying
day
to ignore him.
Day out. You didn't make the rules, but you won't lose. You're a cop and a sprinter and a money printer.
I've made some.
Sure. And has it been easy? Is life easy? Have you not gone into cardiac arrest? Are you not about to have an anxiety attack or shoot yourself in the mouth? But you still hustle 24/7, ride or die. Now, ask yourself, are you rich?
I mean, no, but I'll say yes.
Get out of here. You're a pauper. You work harder than anyone.
Okay.
Almost rode yourself to the grave, and you're still practically a hobo. Why is that?
Fucking taxes.
That's right. 100%. Fucking G-Man's got his jam-covered sticky fingers in your pocket.
As someone who stealing just did his taxes.
Every time you buy, sell, walk,
it's talk, a little close.
Fart, so much as sneeze. Every time you wipe your ass, they got their direct and their indirect modes of taxation. Sales tax.
Damn ass wiping tax. Duty,
extraction tax. Alimony. One tax that doesn't even have a name. Plus there's the stuff people in other countries pay for. That makes them ask for more money from you. Here. Total tax duties add up to 98% of all your money.
I don't think that's right.
What are you not sure about? They're milking your nipples till they bleed. Can't you see? Aren't you sick and tired of having bloody nipples?
I guess I'm a free market fundamentalist now.
Here you go, hustler. Fight the righteous fight. Free the people. Keep it real. Keep it street. Keep foaming at the mouth furiously on the tax issue.
Cool. Money, money, money. Oh, that's a thought. Okay. 42% on that one. 42%. I like how you have the option here, like maybe to sit and ruminate on finger pistols and indirect modes of taxation. Just, you know, standard topics of thought. Bureaucrat, yeah, they're still on strike. Other hour of your life gone. Let's talk to the lorry drivers again.
Stuck in the rain in a traffic.
What are you hauling?
Time to arrest him.
What are you
can't
actually
even
hauling?
Get a few jokes past you.
No, I like this guy. I like Tommy.
The oxidant,
nothing illegal.
They've legalized sports equipment while I was on the road.
Okay.
The man.
I want it to be the racist guy. I don't want to arrest this guy. This guy seems nice. He just wants to get home to his family. This guy though, he's kind of an asshole.
Looking for something odd.
What are you hauling?
Not much anymore. I'm here to pick up some cargo, but the dock workers are on strike, so...
What kind of cargo? Apples?
Yeah, he's given you the runaround. Let's be honest. You were bested.
What? What are you hauling?
Not much anymore.
What kind of cargo? Apples?
Yeah, he's given you the runaround. Let's be honest.
Rhetoric?
You were bested.
I can't level it up anymore. What are you hauling?
Not much anymore.
What kind of cargo? Apples?
Yeah. He's given you the runaround.
What are you hauling? What kind of cargo? Apples?
Yeah. He's given you the runaround.
What are you hauling? What kind of cargo? Apples?
Yeah. He's given you.
It's just gonna fail every time. Yeah, I didn't think it actually would, but it was worth a shot. I thought maybe if I just said the same thing over and over, you would kind of just go crazy and admit to hauling drugs. My biggest complaint with this game, and really like my only actual complaint, is that just moving around is a pain in the ass. It's an absolute pain in the ass. Like, the writing more than makes up for it, but still. Go around the goddamn truck, man. Yeah, I figured it'd be better on PC.
Right to work. Shame on you.
Where exactly are you from?
What's it to you?
Part of the investigation.
Am I a suspect? Done no crimes. I only fight for the rights of people.
I'm interested in your background.
We're all workers, right? Workers stick together. Came from the eminent domain, in Jamrock. Backgrounds in odd jobs, heavy lifting, cargo hauling, bouncer work.
I already said all these things.
I know the drill. Worked at Territorial. Ring a bell? Uh-huh. It was a long time ago.
Whatever. So we're not going to get anything out of the driver. Not getting anything out of the lady from Wild Pines. I could take Everard's job, but I don't. I've already done more than I want to for him. I already kind of regret doing the first job. These stairs, especially. That's me just holding down, man. Go down the fucking stairs. Jesus. I hope there's a quest line somewhere that'll let me install an elevator there, so I don't have to use those stairs. Is there anything else? I don't expect anything to be going on in the whirling, but
the door is closed.
Try the handle.
This door can only be opened with a key or from the inside.
Knock.
Still no answer.
I mean, I think that that's...
Still, you should punch a fucking hole in it.
Suppress the urge.
Murmur in your ears.
We're not gonna do that again.
Slowly.
Yeah, you can go out here. There's a roof, too, though. There's somebody up on the roof. I've not been there. Isn't this Kim's room, right? I should have sent the poet. Yeah, it's locked. Okay. I figured it would be. Be a tape, but it was destroyed in a fit of rage. Huh. Oh, that. The pattern on the wall here is from The Shining, isn't it? Isn't that from the hotel carpet in The Shining? Very distinct pattern. Oh, was that a big stretch? Hey, buddy. Come here. Hello. Sit in my lab for a little bit before breakfast. Good kitty. I don't think we just wait. We just wait for Kim to get back. I'd like to know how to get up there and talk to her. I think there's other stuff that we could do tonight. Like, we still need to go talk to the smoker on the balcony. Apartment number 28. Sing karaoke. A sad song on tape. Still don't know who reported the crime. No badge, no gun, no ghoul, no bool. Ghoul. Oh, so you're so cute. Hi. Yeah. And there's a lot of stuff that we can do across the water lock, but...
There are eight. You won't get far without the lieutenant here to bounce thoughts off of. Where could he be?
This cat is a little cuddle machine today. You just want attention? All right. Hi, buddy. Stop it. No. No chewing on cables. Right? Get down. Time to get down. God.
You
delicious.
Sit on the wind-worn wooden planks of the bench. Your feet ache.
I mean, really, I think we should wait, like, 6 hours. But... I don't know, it feels like just waiting. Let's think deep thoughts.
You finally stop picking your nose.
Stare to the sky.
Time passes.
Let's just see if any of those things actually...
The sun does its best to ward off the chill of the coast. It barely helps. As if...
Put all your thumbs. It's an hour and 45 minutes spent on a bench.
Your hands warm.
Yeah, I know reading those too. Yeah. I was on one of the loading screens. Briefly. I don't know, without Kim here, I can't really think of much else to do, so I think we just kind of wait till tomorrow, and then we have access to the other side of Martinez. Don't I have a,
The face,
yeah, I can
of
read
Kim
a book.
Friesel smiles at you, for some reason.
Put it away. All right, I think maybe I will call it a little early today. Call it a little early. This feels like a good place to stop. I don't know what else I want to do right now. I've got to go get ready for a training at work. But yeah, thank you guys for hanging out. We will probably get back with Kim tomorrow when we continue this. Hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day. See you again soon.